Hi everyone, hope all of you have gone through the first section. Today we are going to deal with the formation of image after the reflection. Okay, we know that from an illuminated object, the light will be emitting to the all direction, like 360 degree we will get the light emitted from the illuminated object. And we know that if you want to find out the position of an image, minimum we require two incident rays. From any point we can consider, we need two minimum rays. So after the reflection, sometimes these ray will intersect at a point, or sometimes it will diverge, or we feel it appears to come from a point. On the basis of this, we can divide the images into two categories, real image and virtual image. We studied this in 7th standard and even in 8th standard. Real image and virtual image. So we'll see what is the differentiation between the virtual image and real image. So real image, we know that after the reflection, the light rays will come and join or meet at a particular point. And if you are keeping a screen on that particular point, we will get the image on the screen. So first one, we have to get the intersection of refracted ray after meeting the point, and we need to get the image on the screen. And the third point is that we never get any erect image, or always the real image forms an inverted image. If this is the object, as in the case of real image, we should get an inverted image. That is the most speciality or the most important point related with the real image. If we consider the case of virtual image, we are very familiar with the word virtual. So we know that what's the meaning of virtual? It's not real. So in this case, we never get the rays are intersecting at a point, or we feel like it appears to come from a point. And if we keep a screen in front of the refracted ray, we never get the image on the screen. And the last most important point related with the virtual image is we will always get an erect image. And always we used to represent the virtual image with a dotted line. Don't forget that. So these are the three differentiation between the real image and virtual image. And in 7th standard, we studied how to draw the image formation of a point object if we keep in front of a plane mirror. We'll see how we'll get the image formation. Just consider this is our mirror, and we know that one side we always do like this way to show it's a quartered line. Either it will be with the silver oxide or mercury. And here I'm going to mark the point object. We used to keep it as, I'm just going to write it as O. And we already discussed that minimum we require two lines to find out the intersection. So first ray is going to meet here. This is our first incident ray. And we know that this is incident ray. Then what we have to do it now? We have to draw a normal at the point of incidence. And we know that all these rays are following the laws of reflection. So what is the angle of incident? The same angle it has to reflect back to the same medium. This is our incident ray and this is our reflected ray. I am marking it as I1 and R1. This is the first ray. Same way, we require one more ray. It's also coming from the same point. These are another incident ray. So it's I1. And here also we have to draw the normal. Here I am marking it as N1. And here we will mark it as N2. So two normal for two different incident ray. And here same way it also will be moving like this. So this is our R2. So this is the way how actually after the refraction the light rays are moving. And from this place we used to see the object. So if we are in front of the mirror, the way how we are seeing the object is that we have to extend these lines. I didn't take any measurement, so I'm just going to draw it as a rough figure. So if we extend this figure, at a point, always the extended lines also should be in a dotted line. Don't draw it as a continuous line, you never get the mark for that. So if we extend the line, at a particular point we will see that these two lines are joining each other. So this is a image. We have to mark it as I. O for object and I for image. This is the way if you are keeping the point object in front of a mirror or a plane mirror, we will get the image. Okay. And if you are keeping, instead of the point object, if you are keeping an extended object, how we will get the image? That also we will see right now. for that case, I'm going to draw the mirror like this way. It will be easy for you to understand. So one side is coated with a silver oxide. And here I'm going to keep an object. Okay. So just consider it's a pencil. This is the tip of the pencil and this is the pointed edge. Okay, I'll draw it like that as such. Okay. This is the head and this is the point. Okay. So for an extended object, we need to draw two set of rays from the bottom position and from the head position. I'm starting from the bottom. So two rays, here four set of lines will come. So I'm not going to draw the normals. So these are incident ray. After striking, it will be moving like this way. Another one, same way, strike over here. Then it will pass. So first I'm going to join these two lines. If we extend these lines, so this is our tip. And same way from the head also, we are going to draw two set of lines. After striking, it will pass like this way. Another ray, same way, it will be moving. So if we extend these two lines, here we will get another point. Okay, so this is our head and this is our tip. Little bit variation is there, but still it will be like this way. So this is the way how we will get the extended rays after the image formation. These point also you studied in last year, even in 8th standard and 7th standard also we deal with the same portion. And one more point we studied that if you are standing in front of the mirror, we'll get the same size. We'll get the same size if you're 1 meter in front of the mirror. We'll see the image also 1 meter inside the mirror. We will prove that with an example. So only we study the theory part. Here we are going to prove it with the example. Okay. So here also we are going to take a point object. This is a mirror. Then here this is the object. Okay. I'll just mark it as O. One ray is striking over here and after the refraction it will be passing like this way. And another one I'm going to taking it as which is falling normally on the figure. Okay. If the incident ray is falling normally on a surface, the refracted ray also will be following the same path. That means here the angle of incident is zero. So the angle of refraction also will be zero. So these are the two points, two lines or two rays which we are going to consider. So this way if we extend, it will come like this way. If we extend this line, this is the way how it will extend. Okay. So I'm going to give some names for this one. Here I'm marking it as F. This is our image. This is A. And here we have our normal, N and C. So here the angle is I. And here the angle is R. Okay. And in mathematics, we are going to apply some mathematical theories in this figure. I hope you know the correspondence angle and the alternative angles. So just consider this angle O, A, N. And this angle, these are corresponding angles. So this I, if this angle is I, automatically this angle also will be I. Or I'll write over here. Angle AOF is equal to angle OAN. It's equal to angle I. Okay. Same way, consider this angle and this angle. These angles are correspondence angle. So we will get angle CAN is equal to angle AIF, that is equal to angle R. Okay. Now this is I and this is R. Now we are going to take this triangle and this triangle. If we consider these two angles are 90 degree each, or this AF will be common for both the triangles. So we can tell that, or if we consider in that case, we can write it as FO is equal to FI. That means this is our object distance and this is our image distance. So we can prove with the figure both object distance will be equal to the image distance. Okay. And in this section, we are moving to the last point, that is lateral inversion. So when we see the ambulance, we know that it now will be written in a normal form. It's like a mirror image. That is what we call as lateral inversion. Lateral inversion means the left side seems like right side and the right side seems like left side. So we are utilizing that application in our day-to-day life in ambulance. So we know that when the driver which is moving above the or front of the ambulance, when normally the drivers will be watching the rearview mirror, and that is in that way only they can see what is happening behind the vehicle. See, if an ambulance is coming in a hurry, so the driver can watch through the rearview mirror, and so they can correctly they can read it as ambulance. So for that purpose, always the ambulance letters are always written in a mirror image version. So now we are going to conclude the properties of the image formed by a plane mirror. First one, always it forms a virtual image and it will be erect in nature. And the third point, it shows a lateral inversion. And the fourth point, the image distance will be always equal to the object distance. Which all the topics, the last section and this section, what we studied is exactly the repetition of the things what we studied in 7th standard. I think it's 7th standard. So please refer your 7th standard book and prepare the note for this one. Thank you.